Hi, this is Joel Rosenberg, founder and editor-in-chief of All Israel News and our sister site, All Arab News, coming to you from Jerusalem, from a studio here in Jerusalem where we have a special guest. Over the next three interviews, we are going to be talking to an Israeli presidential candidate. I know you're thinking we are still trying to work our way through the prime minister discussion and decisions and see if who will be the next prime minister of Israel. But as of July 9th, we will have a new president, the head of state, and candidates are beginning to emerge, and we're interviewing the first of our series, Yehudah Glick, a former member of Knesset. Yehudah, it's an honor to be with you. Thank you for joining us on All Israel News.
Thank you so much for inviting me, Joel, and it's really my pleasure to talk to you and through you to the crowd.
Sounds good. So Yehudah, I want to begin by asking you, how do you see the role of the president of Israel, especially in contrast to the role of prime minister? Well, let's start there, because then we'll go into what's your vision and why you.
Well, thank you so much, Joel, for the question. It's really a pleasure to be able to speak here from Jerusalem. In Israel, there's the political system, where there's prime minister, parties, parliament, but there's also the president. The president of Israel is the embodiment of the state of Israel. He actually represents the state of Israel, and I would say in three circles. Circle one, number one, is the Israeli society. There are so many arguments, I would say, sometimes even very strong friction between the divide between the people in Israel, and people see things in various different perspectives. There's a need for somebody who can actually be able to, I would say, like the conductor of an orchestra. Somebody who you don't see his face even, he doesn't play on any of the instruments, but he's there to make sure there's a symphony, and it's not a whole bunch of noise. And you need somebody who really can feel and listen and genuinely identify with all the different parts of the Israeli society. That's number one. The second circle that the Israeli president represents is to the Jewish people around the world. There are so many Jews around communities, many, many of them around the world, and they refer to the president of Israel not only as the president of the state of Israel, but as the president of the people, the Jewish people. And number three, not less important, is the representative of the state of Israel, the face of the state of Israel to the nations. And here, if you had told me a year ago that I would be running for president, I would say it's impossible. But as much as you can trust somebody who was in politics, I wouldn't say a politician, but somebody who was in politics, I really am here on this mission. I feel that I was assigned to do this. I feel that the strings are being pulled on my head, and I'm pulled into this mission. I really have been following up with the Israeli society for many, many years, but last year meeting with all different parts of the society, and I feel this is something that somebody, they need somebody who's identifying, on the one hand, an Israeli patriot, on the other hand, somebody who can really have a true, genuine dialogue with all the different segments of the Israeli society, ultra-Orthodox, secular, European origin, Ashkenazi, Sephardi, academic, whatever, all the different parts of the Israeli society, and to be able to identify with them, the academic world and the religious world, and to be able to create a real, genuine unity, a real genuine respect from all parts of the Israeli society.
The role of the presidency is the head of the state, not the head of the government. So the day-to-day political machinations and intrigue regarding specific policies, specific laws, that's the role of the prime minister. The president is a bigger picture, almost the ambassador of the country outside of politics.
Yeah, that's true, but sometimes that can sound like, oh, he's a symbol, he's like a flag, you know, he's just a statue, and he'll sit in his house. But here I am coming and saying, guys, I'm ready to roll up my sleeves and to work on it, because the Israeli society is suffering from this divide, and we need somebody who actively will meet with the people, I would say highlight the good, beautiful sides of all different parts of the Israeli society, and try to create not only a dialogue, not only tolerance, inclusiveness, try to create that everybody, every part of the Israeli society, male or female, disabled or anything you want, people should be able to feel that they are respected in society. And this is something that I was blessed when I served in the Knesset 3 years. I was part of one party, the Likud, but all my activity, all I did was always building cooperations. I led a caucus in the Knesset that dealt with dialogue between religious and non-religious. The caucus that dealt with the dialogue between Jews and Muslims. Mm. I was very much involved in promoting legislations that were on a consensus, anti-smoking activity, promoting EpiPens for those who have allergies. The whole idea to run a respectful dialogue between people, it's something that doesn't happen by itself, especially when we're living in a world, I would say a world of talkbacks, a world of social media. In that kind of world, you need somebody who can say, guys, okay, you said what you said, now let's make sure you can listen to the other side. Don't come to panels and say, how, look, you see how I showed it to him, you see how I gave it to him. Come to panels to listen to each other.
So on that note, it's interesting, the two most recent presidents, and of course these are 7-year terms, and you get one term, so it's a, and it's decided by the Knesset, not by the nation at large. It's a secret vote, secret ballot inside the parliament. So the last two rounds have been, one was a left-wing president, Shimon Peres, and more recently, right-wing Ruvi Rivlin. Now, in both cases, it's interesting, they'd had very, highly, intensely partisan political careers, and then decided to sort of come, in my view, these are my words, but to sort of see the presidency as the grandfather of the nation, like dialing it down politically and find a way to build consensus. Is grandfather of the country, is that a good model? How would you describe, is there a metaphor that you would apply?
First of all, I love grandfathers. I love fathers. I just became a grandfather for my 11th grandchild last week.
Wow.
And my father just has his 117th great-grandchild.
Wow.
So I'm a big fan of grandparents. But I think that also in grandparents, there's somebody who can sit being very passive. And very often, people look at this mission of being president. You know, I had a good political career. Now let me have something with some kind of dignity and respect.
It's not a retirement plan.
A retirement plan. And so you should retire from a good position, where a respectful position. I'm looking at the presidency as something to be very, very active. To be there, to run around. First of all, the house of the president will be open for all of Israelis. Mm. And I'm going to invite all of Israelis to come. And I will be going out. I'll be going out to the field. I'll be so active, because that's what I am. I don't know if people realize all Israel news is colored, it's not black and white. So you'll see my red hair. It's part of my, I would say, characteristics of really caring. And that's what I've been doing all my life. When I do something, when I take a mission, I do it. And that's where I feel that we need that. We can't, you know, I'm just another president, just so you'll see and be a symbol. It's an expensive expense for the Israeli taxpayer. And I think if we can really give an essence to this presidential mission, I am there. I'm there because I really believe in the people of Israel. I believe in the people of Israel, and I'm there for them. And I'm there to really create this unity, not just as a word to be said, but actually true, dignified unity.
Well, in such a deeply divided society, that's going to be an enormous challenge, but it's also, I think, an intriguing objective. And in the next two interviews, I'd certainly like to chat with you about the fact that you're an immigrant, and not so much an Ole Chadash, a new immigrant anymore, but I'd like to talk about your journey from the United States to becoming a citizen of Israel, and I want to meet your wife, Hadass. I want to see what role she plays in your life, and you've both experienced some real tragedies and some pain, so we want to get into that. And then in our third segment, I want to talk to you about what's the president's mission? What's your mission when it comes to Christians in Israel and around the world, about other minorities, the Abraham Accords? We'll get into all of that.
I just like one last sentence. I think that the very fact that I come from a Western American background has an impact on my ability to be inclusive. Not always, I think, and thanks to my parents, and you spoke about grandparents, but thanks to my parents and thanks to my American Anglo-Saxon Western values, is also the ability to be a little more calm and a little bit more inclusive and not so dogmatic.
Wonderful. Yehudah Glick, a former member of Knesset from the Likud Party, which is on the center right, running for president of Israel. And by July 9th, we will know, that's the last moment. We will probably know that before that, because that's the day that the current president will be moving out and a new one moving into the presidential residence. I'm Joel Rosenberg for All Israel News in Jerusalem. Thank you for joining us.